Hey guys, welcome to part 3 of episode 2 of my Wide and Happy series. This is Spanish Mesa, Gibraltar. In the last part, we had settled our third natural wonder. We sent a settle towards a fourth one, which will require us to take land from Mongolia, who was one of the witnesses to my eliminating Shaka. So that will probably provide some tensions. And we had found a fifth natural wonder, the last one, and it does look like it might be settleable. So this should be a pretty good segment, I think. I'm starting on the loading screen here because I wanted to draw attention to Spain's UA. Something I didn't point out in the beginning because it was something I wasn't even aware of myself is when it says that happiness is doubled, I used to think that was like things like Fountain of Youth, the natural wonders that provided happiness. But it turns out it also is for when you discover. So that's kind of nice because Spain's UA is kind of a gamble, and in the event that you should lose that coin toss, you at least get the benefit of having additional global happiness. So that's nice. Anyways, let's reacclimate ourselves with where we were. I think I was mostly done with the turn. Yeah, there's the fifth wonder land nearby. I'm gonna have to scout some more to see what's going on there. We do have a settler being brought up in the capital. It was originally going to be a canal city here, and I guess I should talk about that for a second too. I kind of mentioned before that I wanted to try out sacred sites. It's something I haven't done before, and I've heard others talk about it. So, and I know I've been doing a lot of culture victories lately, but this map is really going to lend itself to that because we did get very easy religion with two religious buildings, and I'm looking to settle a city here, settle a city here. Both of these will be canal cities. This one will get us a unique luxury. Might settle here. This settler's coming down to settle on top of the cocoa, and I should drop a citadel as soon afterwards as possible to grab this natural wonder. I'm thinking maybe a city here would be good. If India doesn't settle in this area, it'll get me, I have bananas, some salt, some fur, which is a unique luxury, which is nice. And more importantly, it would make this disjointed city a little more connected to my empire long term. And I was also kind of noticing, if we're going to settle this far, what's coming over here. I'm saying, okay, there's iron and some gems and horses and river. Cocoa and bananas too, but I'm sure their borders will go first. I'm going to scout some more and see what's going on over here. So we're going to be playing really, really wide. And of course, if I annex Ulundi, I could buy some faith buildings in that city as well. So we're going to have a lot of faith buildings. And if I can get a Reformation belief, that'll for sacred sites, that'll be a lot of tourism. Kind of hard to pass up, really. Okay, so we got a worker here who's building roads this way. We got a worker here that's kind of building roads, hooking up horses. And we've got this worker here. I'm thinking about dropping a city here and here, so I kind of need workers over here. This worker's dealing over here, mostly hanging around to get the marble, but I want to hook the river farms up as well. I got two workers coming down this way to handle this city and this city. Although this city won't need much, I'll hook up the farm here and then the horses, and that'll kind of be it. For those just joining in, as you can see from enhanced user interface, Mongolia is offering incense. That deal's been up for a little bit, but I've been holding off because I'm about to take some of my own, and that would be redundant. We do have construction, obviously, since we're going towards engineering here, so I'm going to upgrade my archers. I do got to be careful though. It seems like we got a lot of gold, but if I do settle over here, I'm going to want to buy a granary right away to be able to work Krakatoa. And of course, when I settle this city, I'm going to want to buy a granary right away so I can work King Solomon's mines. That'll be 12 hammers and 8 faith. Since we do have a missionary in tow, we'll be able to convert the city right away. So that'll be a really good tile that I'll want to work immediately, so I'll need a granary. And that'll be nice because then the second tile I want to work will be the river wheat, and that'll help me grow to 3 pop relatively quickly. So that's kind of where we're at here. See what other. So maybe I move the worker to this side of the river. I can put a farm here, perhaps. Start building roads down here, maybe. I don't know. There's not too much going on over here, but there will be more of a demand soon enough, so that's not the easiest call to make. Go ahead and heal up a turn. Sit tight, and that's it for this turn. Okay, enough babbling. Let's get on with the game, shall we? No longer friends with Hong Kong. That's unfortunate. We're down to 3 happiness. Okay, that city's grown, so we can work the extra science and the extra faith. That's really good, because we're going to be playing so wide. Science is kind of going to be a problem. Although not really, partially because we're working science here. We might be working science over here. Let me check now that it's next turn. Oh. Yeah, okay, so horses, stone. I can settle here, buy that tile. I'll get the fish. I wonder how... I don't like settling on top of sheep. Because I lose out the food. But, there's all these tiles. None of them's really worth settling onto. They're all a bit of a toss-up. Oh, and okay. I'm happy to see that because... and a city-state. Neat. We are playing on a Pangaea map. And when I found a landmass over here, I was like, uh-oh. Because I was afraid maybe a civ was going to be stationed out here or something. But with that ruin there, that doesn't look to be the case. Okay, settlers done here. And we do think... I do think that settling over here is going to be something I want to do. So, let's look at happiness for a second. When this settler comes down here, I'll settle on the cocoa, which is a unique luxury, so my happiness won't change. I'll drop a citadel here, so my happiness will actually go up by 4. So when I drop this city, I'll still be at 3 happiness. And I got 3 coliseums online, so I'm going to go ahead and build another settler, get this canal city up as soon as possible. Yeah, that's probably good. For that reason, one turn till engineering, and then I'll go optics so these guys can get embarkation and come over and settle this 5th one. And then another thing I can do is buy my last missionary and convert one of these cities and hop into the water and convert this city so I get faith right away. That'll make that worth working right away. Instead of buying a granary, I could also build a cargo ship here because engineering is going to give us another trade route. And then I'll have a canal city, so I should be able to send a food trade route to there. I don't know if that's such a good idea, though, because right away I'm only going to have the horse and Krakatoa worth working. And until I get a monument built, my borders are going to grow relatively slowly. I'll probably pick up the stone next, but that's it. So that city doesn't need to grow all that big all that quickly, I don't think. So let's get a farm there. Okay, let's deal with this situation. India's not dropping, so that's good, but they're also not budging, so that's kind of bad. Let's move this guy over here, this guy here. I still kind of want to blockade India, so we'll use the missionary as kind of a blockade. Let's get the settler moving in. Now these guys can come down. Okay, I'll go ahead and shoot this and defend. Let's see here. You know, that's not a bad city spot. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I could settle on the horses to stay on the river. That will increase my... Like, I don't know how fast I'll get over here. It's probably going to be that this city takes up some of these tiles before I can even get a settler over there. If I even want to settle it. This would kind of be like forward settling 3 civilizations at once. Like, I don't mind so much these guys, because I'm already going to upset them here, and I'm going to have the bulk of my military down here to keep them from getting froggy. And I'm not too worried about this, because India tends to be a little bit of a sweetheart. But I'm kind of worried about this. Ram Kim Hang has a notorious reputation for being kind of unpredictable and very insistent. But if I was to build a city, like, on the gold, I'd lose being on the river, but I'd still have access to, like, river farms. So that would be okay. I'd have mountains. I'd be on a hill. Yeah, okay, and rough, rough, rough. So it'd be a pretty defensible city. And we could pick up some iron, a couple gems, be on the gold, got food and production. You know, some science here. That'd be a decent city, actually. Really far away, so it's lower priority than here and even here, I think. But that's where my thoughts are for now. Let's see what's going on here. Ooh. I'll go ahead and hop on the hill because he does have scouting promotions, so that's pretty good. Go ahead and sit tight. And that's it for this turn. Alrighty. Engineering is done. So this opens up. And we got a Colosseum here. Let's see. 13 turns or 10. Gold in the meantime. Gold's kind of strapped a little bit. I don't want to be growing too fast because I'm still planting some cities. Then again, this city kind of stayed back for a while. What would I build next? Aqueduct? Could build a settler. Because the capital's going to drop a settler here and here. I'd like to get a settler over here relatively quickly. The thing is after I take optics, I'm going to be heading for workshops. And I tend to prioritize them when playing wide because you can benefit from the production boost. Excuse me. So I'd like to have all my cities established before that just because otherwise my build queues are going to get backed up. They kind of already are. Like in the capital, I haven't built a Colosseum yet. We just got aqueducts, which I don't value the aqueducts too highly when playing wide, but other people say it's worth it. So it's something I try to pay attention to in an attempt to improve my own skill level. Let's keep on going for this road because it won't be established by the time the city's here, and I do want to connect this city. Because we are playing Liberty, and in 6 turns we'll have our next social policy, and we'll get our great scientists we can drop there. So I'll be having some happiness coming in from city connections. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. 3 right away. Plus there's the secondary happiness, 1 in 20 citizens or something. So we'll get like 4, maybe. I don't know, so. Alright. This city is falling a little behind, so let's go ahead and build an aqueduct. And I am going to work the growth over the gold tiles, simply because the aqueduct will be done shortly before the next citizen. So we'll get the maximum effect from the aqueduct right away. I kind of want to keep this guy on this half of my empire for now, so I'm going to go ahead and start building a farm there. This city was dwarfed for a little while because we were working the high production tile. But I think happiness is beginning to stabilize. We're not trying to be too eager about it. But, India's starting to move back. That's pretty good. I'm going to step and shoot. And shoot here so that we can clear the camp. I am going to move my melee units down in here so that my great general can hopefully actually set up the citadel on the turn that I... Yeah, that'll work. On the turn that I dropped the city. Okay, so border and mountain, let's tie it back. I want to find out more about Siam here. I'll step up on the hill for visibility. Now we gotta head back. Hope he doesn't box us in. And we were first to meet him. So that's good. Tells us a little bit about who's got boats and where they're sending them. That's pretty good. Nice visibility chunk there. Let's see here. We'll wait one more turn. And then we can hop in and get some embarkation. Alright, you keep on heading down here. What was that? I have met Sidon. I sure have. And there goes India. I hope that continues, actually. Because if he pulls out altogether, then that means this could be our settle and, that'd be really nice as far as getting the kingdom to stay together. Let's see here. However, I do think I'm gonna keep a guy here just to dissuade him from coming back. I don't know how effective that'll be, but whatever. Okay, so there's quite a bit of water here. But I want to send my boat back to act as a military escort. I'm about to drop a couple of units into the water. And I'd like to be able to protect at least the settler. The composite bowman will be able to heal up, so that's not a problem. Okay, Seville is done. Let's go ahead and build a cargo ship. We're far enough along that it'll be better to have cargo ships rather than caravans. Okay, we can't take another step, and there's no point in stepping off the hill. Okay, let's see here. 4 turns until border growth, so you can work on a farm there. And there we go, getting some good visibility. I'm going to have him just keep bouncing back and forth, keep an eye on that. Let's hope these borders don't close. Alright. Go, India, go away, go away.
You made an instrument.
Alright, so we can pick up embarkation. Oh, good. A river tile. Yeah, we'll build a farm there next. That's good. Okay, now we're allowed to pass. Alright, looks like we're going to be freed up there. 2, 3, 4. Start a farm. Take one step to view that. Let's see here. I'll wait one more turn. I want to drop him in the water. Military units in the water can't occupy the same space as civilians like they can on land. So I got to make sure I keep these guys traveling separately. Alrighty, this little mess down here, let's keep that going. Alright, protect all my civilians. Except this one, that's okay.
Made it.
Alrighty, I'm glad to see that that came before we settled over here. Not that that's going to happen anytime soon, but it's helpful if,
Indeed, don't rub.
Oh, good. He's able to give us 2 gold for one.
Nah, no.
All right. That means the fact that he saw us take out Shock is not going to be all that used against us. Okay. Wow. I've got 3 civilians here that are going to disappear next turn. Okay. I can purchase with faith. About to drop a city here. So if I bought a missionary here, maybe I could convert this city and then come and convert this one. Oh wait, you know what? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. And we do have itinerant preachers, don't we? Yes. Okay, so it's 13, not 10. Okay, so I'll convert this city rather than this city. I wanted to do this city because the higher population means it'll take it longer to flip naturally. But if I do this city, I'll be influencing Sidon right away. So that's, I think that's better. So let's go ahead and buy a missionary in this city. And I'm not too worried about the settler that's coming here. This city will convert very rapidly. It'll have 1, 2, 3, 4. This will probably influence too. It'll convert pretty quick. Plus, there's not a lot of growth in that city, so its population will stay low. And that's kind of nice when you're waiting for a passive conversion like that. Alright, so I started an aqueduct here. I could start a settler here to settle down here. The only problem with that is I'm already looking at this as a possible guild city. And when you're playing wide, choosing what cities are going to be your guild cities are really hard. Like, this one's not too hard. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now 6 tiles worth working. So, you know, population 7, 8, where are they going to go? I mean, we're going to have universities as well, so I might just build one guild in here. That's also a reason why I want to annex Ulundi eventually. All these river tiles and stuff. I could probably make this a guild city as well. So, because I've got so many cities work, you know, that have a citizen working a tile. Like, this is the only one that provides growth. So, I'm actually considering building a settler there. Anyways, let's go ahead and embark. He's got to get out of the settler's way, so I'll put one turn into a road here and then move back next turn. It's going to take him 2 turns to get up there regardless, so we'll have the worker continue on the road, and he can stop a little short. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's working out pretty good. Alright, time to make some decisions here. do I want to build a settler here? When I drop this city and then the citadel, I'll actually go up 4 happiness. When I drop a city here and here, I'll go down 8. So that'll leave me at 4 global happiness, or 4 happiness total, actually. And we're done with the happiness buildings. But our faith will have, well, we can't really count it out because we're about to be gaining 8 more faith per turn from that city. So, and then from this city. It all comes down to how quickly we'll be able to get that. Alright, with this city going, getting ready to grow in 5 turns, and me thinking that might be a guild city, I'm thinking maybe not build a settler here. Okay, we'll have him just keep hopping back and forth to keep all the visibility going. Alright, so in this city I could build a settler and bring it up here. And then build a work boat, settle it here. Oh, and plus we've got the marble coming. Okay, so the capital will build a settler to make my last canal city. And then I'll figure out what to do over here as I know more. Go ahead and sit tight. Alrighty, now the fun begins. We're going to steal some land from Mongolia. Okay, wish me luck. Settle a city. Before I choose production, let's go ahead and drop that. He's upset, understandably so. But that means we're going to work this tile right away. Buy a granary. Look at these build times. 3 turns for a monument. That's excellent. Let's go ahead and convert. So we got 8 more faith coming in. Alrighty, so we'll have, 5 turns, and we'll start buying happiness buildings. That's really good. Oh, you know what? I totally forgot that he was attacking Geneva. Okay, well maybe that'll serve as a distraction. However, it might be that if I settle here, he might count that as a forward settle as well. Because I'm kind of encroaching in his mid-ground. I don't know. Like, if he asked me not to settle again over here, I don't know what I would tell him. I could shoot that. There's not really a point to it. So let's see here. Keep that going. Alright, keep on moving there. Very good. 2, and boat left as a military escort. That's really good. Alright, he's coming over to convert Budapest. I must say, the synergy is looking pretty nice. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and start moving some of these guys forward. Whoops. Simply because I got a worker coming in, and I do want to work on the farm. Which is a dangerous proposition, because if he wants to go to war right away, this tile's got... In fact, maybe I shouldn't have moved my spearman there right away. Because he's got 2 city bombards, and I'd have to cross a river and still be in range of 1. So this citadel is probably going to be pretty bad as far as defensive. Because it's in range of a city bombard. And he could have, like, various archers attacking it, and somebody over here. So that's not going to be the best defensive tile. Now see, here's the problem I was talking about. If I go to settle by where the furs are, if I say to him I'm not going to settle, and then I settle by the furs, will he count that as a full... You know what? I don't even know. I don't think other civs will be too pissed off if it goes down that way, and he's already going to be upset with me. He saw me take out Shock. I just took some valuable land from him. So, he's pretty much going to hate us all game long. The key is going to be not to get into too many entanglements with him. And the reason why I say that is because if we are going to play Sacred Sites game, which would be a cultural victory, I want to play as peaceful as possible to be able to barter for open orders as cheaply as possible. So that's my thoughts as far as that goes. Okay, so taking the incense got me happiness, got me happiness, got one of my cities growing in, satisfied a city-state quest, so that's pretty good. Alright, so we got a settler coming out that's going to go up here, so maybe this worker can come put a farm here, and then a camp here, and then build a road on the way back. But, what's he going to do in the meantime? Because the settler's going to come out in 2, 3, 4, settle on 5. So he's got, this turn? I could pre-build the roads, as long as I keep an eye on it. That's not a bad idea. Okay, let's head towards Krakatoa. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, and he cleared a path. Oh, he didn't clear a path for us. You butt. Alrighty, so it's going to take this worker time to get over here. I want to have these guys come in and be real forward. I want to dissuade him from attacking. He talked to us, and I believe I told him I'd stop selling. Alright, so mountain border here, the border's there, mountains. So I'm going to have to actually come back through here. And that's not bad. I'll come up and hit the city up and get upgraded to a composite bowman and maybe come scout down here. Because my other scout's over here, isn't he? Yeah, he's over there. So, alrighty, salt is done and nobody wants it. That's unfortunate. Let's put a farm there. 6 turns this will grow. We'll do this salt. Probably borders will grow here to do that salt. Okay, that worker's going to have plenty to do.
Do not wait.
Start that farm. Trespassing in Budapest. Can't do nothing about that.
Indeed, Rob.
Yeah, okay, 2 gold finally. Yeah, I want to trade with Siam as much as possible because he was the other witness to taking out Shaka. And he's already given me 2 gold for a horse, so he's mostly forgiven me for it, it would appear. Alright, I got to try and remember not to finish building any of those road tiles. You come down here for that. Are you done here? You are. Okay. Keep on going. Oh, you know what? I meant to move him back to the... Crap. Totally built the road there. That's useless, and that means it's going to take him longer to get over here. Oh, man, that sucks. This is kind of a pinch point, so we'll do that. Wow, he's not making this easy at all. Okay, he's in the way, but that's okay for now. Let's go ahead and get mill casting up. Let's go ahead and do that. Alright, we'll just leave them guys hang out for now. Okay, so we made a city-state, and hopefully his borders don't close before we can squeak through there. Camp up here, so I gotta be careful. Coming back through here. Oh, good. Last time we were through here, he had a bunch of units. Okay. Well, I knew that was coming. I'm just a little curious as to why the delay. Maybe it was because he was fighting with Geneva. He wanted to wait till he got some troops back before doing that. Or maybe the fact that I'm crowding his borders after having already taken the land. I don't know. Alright, so here we go. Let's see, 9... Okay, so we got 5 happiness from that policy. We also get to choose a great scientist. And I'm going to go ahead and drop that on the iron here. We're already working that tile. We'll lose 1 hammer now and 1 come chemistry, but you can't drop a great person tile improvement on a luxury resource. It will not connect it. The reason why they allow you to connect strategic resources that way is because, say I drop the academy here first, if I discovered iron here, I'd have to uproot an academy just to mine it, and that's no good, so that's why they did that. I'm going to have to turn my workers back on. Well, no, I'll just remember to keep checking this guy. Okay. So I'll have to remember before I end the turn to go back to him. Alright, so we'll drop a city here. Oh, and we clip some tiles from there. That's okay for now. Build a monument first. Have to repair the tiles here. Yeah, that's better. Alright, so there's that. Okay, grew here. That's good. In fact, when I was done with the salt, I should have been working that tile. These tiles I'm just going to leave hang for... Well, no, I'll lock one into there because that's going to become a farm soon enough. I can't do nothing with that city, so let's see here. Go ahead and get embassies going again. It's a mild diplomatic buff. I'll take all I can get at the moment. Okay, last settler is done for now. I do want to build a workboat to get that tile It's going to be 15, well, not quite 15, because once I build the monument, that'll speed up. So let's see, 8 and 15, difference is 7 plus 2, so we can subtract 3 or 4 turns off that. It'll be about 11 turns. So I don't need to build the work boat right away. And it's 6 turns until we grow, so if I build an aqueduct now, it'll finish just before. Like, now that I'm done building settlers, it'd be a good idea to switch from working these ivory tiles to working these farms just to get growth that much sooner, but you don't want... You want the aqueduct to finish before your next growth if you can. Like, if this had 2 turns, I'm not going to rearrange my tiles to do all that, but if you got like 10 or 11 turns and you get the aqueduct first, you can just start translating that extra food right away. I'm actually going to build a Colosseum. Well, aqueduct? Yeah. This is a very high production city, so we're going to get everything we want soon enough. Workshop's coming up. We don't have to build it in the city right away. I think I do want to prioritize the aqueduct over the library. I don't like building libraries in cities that don't have at least 4 pop. At 4 pop, you're at least getting 2 science for the 1 gold upkeep, so that's kind of worth it. But before that, you're just... I don't know, it's kind of inefficient to me. So we'll do the aqueduct first, get some growth going, and then use a... library to multiply it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go ahead and convert that. So now we're working on that city. So that's pretty good. This settler's coming down. I gotta remember to highlight that worker. Alright, highlight that worker so I don't accidentally build another road tile. So come up here, start to work on a road, and then next turn I'll move them both into position. Alrighty, that works for me. Let's see here. 4 turns until I can start building workshops, and I'm going to want to build that next here. I'm already up to 3 citizens. I'll be up to 4 by the time I can finish the library, since I'm going to be doing the workshop first. Alright, aqueduct's done here. Let's see here. Settler in 7. I do want to get another settler out over here. And I'm having a hard time determining where that's going to come from, so I should probably do that here now while I've got the chance. This is a high production city. Oh, but it's going to grow in 1 turn? Okay. So I'll actually wait so I can throw that extra hammer in there. I don't know what to build, though. We are going to be going piety for a reformation belief. In fact, sacred sites is so important to our victory at this point, I might actually take this path ahead of rationalism. Because we've got the academy, we've got some science wonders, so even though we're playing really wide, our science is going to be pretty overwhelming before long. So I'll pre-build a shrine, just because I think once you have organized religion, those buildings become worth building. Not so much the temple when you're playing wide. It's just a lot of hammers and a lot of gold for the maintenance. But shrines are pretty cheap. And when they're producing... Okay, so we got 66 science per turn. And thanks to the National College multiplier, we gained 12. So almost a 20% increase in science per turn. That's pretty good. Okay, he's going to want to hop off into the water... Oh, I can't travel through there. Okay. So I'm going to have him come back and try and protect him. For the moment. Alright, there was an Indian scout around here. I don't know where he ran off to, but I want to secure my settler being able to work over there. Alright, now this is a 3-hammer tile, and this city's working from behind. So I'm actually going to give this tile to that city. Yeah, I lose a turn on the cargo ship, but this city's playing from behind, so that's more important, I think. There we go. That extra hammer will go a ways. Alright, so maybe I have him hop in the water and come over here. Yeah, we're dropping so many cities in this area so quickly, it's actually stretching my workers out. Which is kind of unfortunate, because the roads to here are going to be kind of useless. I do believe that... the value of a road is based on population, so connecting this city by roads pretty useless at the moment. but the ability to connect. I mean, we're playing Liberty, so we'll get the happiness. So it's not, like, worthless, but, right, how long do you have? Okay, we'll finish that up first. There. The city has grown, so now we'll go ahead and build that settler. Still gonna take 7 turns. Okay, same amount of hammers, but more gold, so definitely worthwhile, I think. Crab is coming, so that's good. Alrighty, are we done buying missionaries? I think so. Like, we have a lot more that we could colonize with our religion, but we had such an amazing drop. Oh yeah, that's the other thing I forgot to mention. At the end of the last segment, I noticed that Arabia had dropped a city here. I had never talked about the possibility of settling this myself. I mean, obviously, it would have been really good as far as luxuries go. 4 wine in 1 city, that's huge. And then 2 cattle and bananas, a lot of growth. Depending on where we settle it, we might have even been able to get the truffles, a unique luxury, so that would have been worthwhile. The problem is the city wouldn't have had much production, which is not bad because we, you know, we get high pop with all these food tiles, and then a lot of these tiles have gold. So this would be a good gold city, but not very high production. We have better options, so since we weren't going to get to this anytime soon, I'm kind of glad Arabia did because, as you can see, it kind of acts as an inlet for our religion to start heading south. But we've got a lot of faith buildings that I'm going to want to buy. You know what? I'm not going to pick up that ruin this turn. Just because if it is a population ruin, it would be great if it could go to this city rather than one of my cities down here. So, kind of wishful thinking, but something to keep in mind. And the missionary is looking safe for now, so I'm actually going to have him head up, scout this coast. I have a camp here, so I'm going to probably take the comp bow over there and clear the camp just to get some rep over here. Anyways, okay, we got somebody that wants to buy our salt. I'm going to bother check how much money he has. He doesn't have any.
Yeah.
Or enough, anyways. So let's count out happiness because I want to be able to buy mosques first just because they're more faith. They'll expedite how soon I can build the other buildings. But if I have to, like if I need the happiness, then obviously pagodas first would be better. He can actually come down here now, which means this composite bowman can come over here. Which is really good because I got blind spots here, blind spots here. So, that's not good. So anyways, I'd like to be able to buy mosques first, but I might have to buy pagodas for happiness. Let's see here. We're going to lose 4 happiness there. 4 happiness there. We'll be down to 1. I'll be building a workboat next, so we'll go up to 5. That's coming up, so we'll be up to 9. We got a seller coming up here. That's going to be a while. So I think I can afford to buy a mosque first. I'm going to take that risk. It seems to work like it's going to work out. I guess I should have taken some time to look at our city states as well. Yeah, that's going to be more than 13 turns, so that's good. Okay. He wants to get in the way. Not much I can do about that. Alrighty. So let's see how this goes. This is going to be pretty interesting. Let's go ahead and drop the city. Put it in the production focus. There's no point in buying and working this tile right away until I have my Pantheon here. So I'm just going to work the horse tile for the moment. And now that the city has gone... Okay, well now I have a reason to buy the tile. Because we'll at least work the science. I'll go ahead and buy the granary here. So that we have some growth, we're not just stagnating. Of course, that kind of means I'm sort of going to have to buy this tile when the time comes. Or maybe I'll buy that, I don't know. Anyways, let's continue scouting with the boat. Workers coming over to do some horse work, among other things. Let's see, 11 turns till we have the bison. So I guess we got to go this route, that's okay. And now we got the canal city. What is our trade routes available looking like? Seville to Genoa. Oh, that's a real short jog. Okay. Might even be able to reach Sidon now that we got that canal city. Ooh, what's Siam doing here? I don't know, but I'm glad he's coming up this way rather than this way. I mean, I don't even know if I want to sell that yet. I mean, they've already claimed the cocoa, this banana. That banana's probably next. So, get some visibility here. course, this is coast here, so if he settles along the coast, he might stop me. That kind of looks like coast, too. So this could be like a choke point. If he drops the city there, I might not be able to scout up here. Might not be important, though. Okay, let's drop this city here. We're down to zero happiness. That's not good. Well, we do have some money, so I suppose worst case scenario, I could buy a coliseum or a circus. Trying to save my money, though. Like, I'm thinking after metal casting, if I prioritize machinery ahead of education and get these guys all upgraded to crossbows, then the chances of... Oh, good. Now we can get some money out of this guy. That's actually going to help a lot. Okay, that's kind of goofy. We got requests of road. I'll have to try and keep that in mind. We can do that eventually. Okay, marble's up, so our happiness is fixed for the moment. We have duplicates of salt and dyes, so... Let's see here. We're gonna favor salt just because we got more coming. A lot more coming when we get that other city up. So 120, 218, that's good enough. Alright, so that's a nice surge in gold. And, because I was just talking about maybe having to buy a happiness building, but it doesn't look like it. We got the marble up. We're about to get, the workboat here soon enough, anyways. Alright, aqueduct's done here. We're one turn away from workshop. So I'm going to go ahead and pre-build a shrine. I should be thinking about military units, though. Because I have a nice military, but I'm spreading very wide, and I got the bulk of military here just to keep Mongolia unchecked. So, alright, look at that faith generation. That's very nice. 2, 3, 4. Okay, another city-state. With any luck, they'll be targeting that camp as well. That would be nice. Ooh, elephants. Cool. Alrighty. Well, hopefully I can clear this cloud. This kind of looks like coast. His borders are there, so hopefully I can clear this cloud and get back over here in time. Anyways, we got a worker here. Let's finish up this farm, and then I'll consider you a free agent. Alrighty, let's see here. We'll do that. Okay, well, that's looking good. Okay, we got a farm up here, and I am working that tile, so we got another free agent. Maybe it's time to start throwing a road this way, because I'm going to have three cities down here. On the other hand, these workers are kind of stretched over here. He could be the free agent that starts the roads. What would he do? He's going to be continuing the roads. I got sheep, farm here, maybe iron. Two turn. Okay, that's what you're going to do. No questions. Just come right here and I guess just wait. Alright, workers or warriors coming, so you can start heading over there. Let's go ahead and finish that city connection. Sucks that I forgot to finish that. Or to get off that. It delayed me finishing this, which delayed that city getting a hammer. Okay, not the best of things. Okay, so see, that city converted, no problem. All by itself. Alright, got our second pop, that's good. We'll go to the next pop much quicker. Okay, so let us start withdrawing these guys. The main reason is I don't want to give him additional... He hasn't declared war yet. I don't want to give him additional reason. If nothing else, I want to get my spearmen on this side of the river, because double bombard, come here, still get bombarded. I mean, the citadel would help, but he could basically melt this guy right away. He still kind of can, but at least this way I'm on this side of the river. And I can get out of his bombard range a little quicker. Okay, workshops are available. So you got two turns. I'm going to let you finish that. But you, I want to get a workshop going. That's Toledo. And yes, I know I'm pronouncing it wrong, but I live very near to Toledo, Ohio. That's what I've called it my whole life, so that's what I'm going to call it. All right, I am going to favor the monuments ahead of the workshops, though. And, wait, you gotta build a workboat first. And the reason why I'm gonna go ahead and favor the monuments over the workshops is because we are playing wide, and that increases your social policy cost. That much is obvious. The part that's not as obvious is we're gonna need a lot of social policies. If we want a reformation belief, That's 1, 2, 3, 4 policies. And then, of course, we're going to want rationalism. Plus, we're generating faith like crazy, and we don't have anything to do with it late game, so I'm going to want to finish out rationalism pretty quickly. And that's pretty nice, because ideology-wise, I might go with futurism, just because we're so delayed in getting our guilds up. And with sacred sites, we got a pretty easy cultural victory lined up, so the ability to turn our late... Okay, so that's pretty nice. First to meet them as well. The ability to turn our late arriving great work makers, I think will be good. And that'll free up our social policies to dump all into rationalism, which we'll be taking late because we're going to go for a reformation belief. So that's my thoughts moving forward as far as that. So basically, I'm going to want as much culture as soon as possible. So yeah, I'm going to favor the monuments over the workshops in my newer cities. Okay, so do we want an internal trade route, or do we want to make some more money? Let's see here. This city's going to have plenty of ease growing. This city is going to have a little trouble growing at first, but 30 turns of a cargo ship will actually give us too much population here. This city would be worthwhile, but we've already got 2 pop, and we just don't even have tiles for 3 pop yet, so... I mean, we'll have this tile by time we're up 3 pop, so that's not a problem. Let's get started on the salt. So yeah, let's see, what to do with this guy. Seville to Genoa, that's +8. It's too bad there's not a city we could send to throw our religious pressure elsewhere. Yeah, like Valencia to Budapest, for example. We'll lose some gold, but where is Budapest? Is it worth throwing our religion? That's Budapest. What? Oh, we'd be bringing back religion? Is that what I was seeing? Alright, that's not important. Let's see here. You're getting 12 pressure, you're probably only getting 6. Okay, so hopefully this will be a domino and we'll own that island. As far as that goes, that's going quickly. Especially now that that's converted. Alright, so religion is going well. We don't need to use the boat for religion. And there's not really a good trade route option. There's no point in feeding the capital at this point. Well, maybe. It's going to take a little bit of time to get some happiness buildings up, so I don't want to... Alright, let's use it for gold this time around. And then we can revisit using it for internal later. I don't want to grow my cities too much at the moment. At least not the ones that are already grown. He can build a workshop in good time and the Colosseum and stuff. So, I'm sorry, I was babbling so much I didn't... Genoa, that's right. A real short one. And that's nice, because I don't know, like, is there a barb here? No. Okay, that's good. Because that's the only tile he can get a peer in around here. Alright, we meet our final trading partner. He doesn't have enough gold for our luxuries, but that's okay. Alright, lots of gold going on. Good deal. And that'll help us with the crossbows and off. Yep. Alright, so that's grown there. We can hook up more ivory. That city is converted. Excellent. And keep in mind, we went with church property rather than tithe. So every time another civilization, it's +2 gold. So that's good. Alrighty. I'm gonna keep the gold flowing. Like, this would buy me 1 turn. Not a big deal. We'd lose out on 27 gold. We need all the gold we can get. We're so wide. We've got an agitated neighbor. We got a lot of units we want to upgrade. So I'm going to try to keep the money flowing as much as possible. And I also want to keep some visibility up here. So let's do this. I can't lose track of him. I want to continue to scout. We're not done scouting. But I like that he's nearby. So let's do this. Okay, you're the free agent now. You should start building roads over here. Yeah, let's start getting a road heading that way. I already handled that. Okay, horses, which I just sold to Shijong. Alright, so that's good. get some visibility going up here. I'm not comfortable with that blind spot there. Finally, the worker arrives. He's not going to have much to do either. Connect the horses, connect the stone. Depending on how the tiles grow, put a farm here, chop some forest down here. Chop the forest down here just to goad the governor into growing there rather than into useless water tiles. Because those water tiles are going to be pretty useless for a while here, I think. Okay, I've got a hand axe here, but he's going to get annihilated this turn, so... Ice. Well, I'm still going to go 2, 3, 4, just to get the visibility. This prevents me from trespassing a turn. Not too important, but I'll go ahead and step on this hill just to see as much as I can. And we're good to go. You may have noticed I did turn off workers on this side, and that's because we're playing wide, so I'd rather see that than that. Plus, I never did fully get the catch of, he pillaged a tile. That's mean. That is mean. More importantly, where is he coming from? Like, it's odd that... Seriously, where is he coming from? Like, nowhere... Of all the places he could be coming from to... jump into sight here is kind of weird. Anyways, shoot him. Step down and shoot him. Oh, he's going to pillage my iron, and yeah, this is not going to be fun. Start pre-building a road. Once he's out of the way, I can fix that. Where did that guy come from? City connection established. Salamanca. Oh, yeah, okay. Might as well finish this road, get Seville connected up, help the gold, then I can come back and do the sheep and maybe put a farm here just to get the city growing. Anyways, let's see here, tech-wise. I'm going to continue towards machinery. If we can get machinery, and then we'll expedite the road speed, which is really helpful, as wide as we plan. But I think once I can get these guys upgraded to crossbows, then I will be... pretty much secure in my fight with Mongolia. I'd really like to know where that guy came from. Like, I don't even know where to send my units. Like, this guy's a scout, so he can, like, cross terrain easier. But I don't want to, like, totally withdraw down here. Anyways, happiness. We do have a settler coming out soon. Come down here, we got a unique luxury there, so not going to be too much of a problem. So I think we can afford to buy another mosque. Yeah, and I'm actually going to buy it in this city. I want the borders growing in the city as much as possible, because this worker is basically going to hook up a few tiles and then head back away. And so let's get those borders growing as fast as possible here. And the reason why is because I just jumped up from one culture per turn in the city to 3, so that's going to expedite border growth. So that's good. And since we're doing the mosques first, that's increasing our faith, which will allow us to get the pagodas sooner. All of which is getting us more culture per turn sooner, which will get us to our reformation belief faster. So it's a nice little system we got going on here. Alright, aqueduct's done in this city. I don't need a workshop in this city. In fact, if I build a coliseum first... Well, 10%, yeah. Okay, I think we can afford to wait. And then by then, it might be time to build the library there. Alright, so get those horses online. And the hand axe was indeed dealt with. So let's go ahead and get out of here. Oh! I wanted to step on that hill. The AI is being so mean to me. Not really, but... Okay, he did pillage that, which is no surprise. Although I must say, I am surprised that... Okay, I can't bring my worker over here this turn, because he could just go 1, 2, 3, 4. Because I'm thinking I want to step and shoot. Oh, there's the camp! Oh, I couldn't find it because it was a camp. It was unoccupied. Okay. Well, mystery solved, which is very good, because I'd rather this scout be able to resume scouting. Like, I don't regret bringing this guy over the river. but I didn't want to go full retreat. Plus, if I bring him over here to scout down here, then, no, I guess we'll head down this way. See what's going on down there. Well, we will have a settler coming over, I don't know. Well, if we bring him closer to Geneva, then, he'll see that we're still around and maybe not get too ambitious. Ivory for silver and some iron. Well, the iron was because it got pillaged, right? Anyways, ivory for silver, I definitely want to continue that. We need all the happiness we can get for now. Toodles grown, good deal. Alright, you want to buy ivory and you have the money for it. Will you actually give me 7? I believe he should. Awesome. We are forgiven in his eyes. That is so cool.
Wederom gegroet.
You don't have much money. How long has it been since I've traded with him? I'm still trading with him. Alright, he's got more money and he's a scarier neighbor, so I'd like to take his money away. Okay, that city will grow. That's nice. Let's see. I think I was pre-building a road there at some point, so that city connection should be connected just a touch faster, I think. Let's see, I want to be able to step and shoot, so let's come up on the hill here. And more horses. Can't even find buyers for the ones we got. Now that we know where the camp is, I don't need him to defend the worker. That's good enough. Hop up on the hill. Okay. I'd like to hop up on this hill for the visibility, I just don't know if taking another 2 turns of side jog is going to be worth it. Like, I don't know where that Siam settler went. And it did have an escort, so I highly doubt that this camp... Oh yeah, that's right. He could go 1, 2, 3, 4. But then I could recapture the... But that would prevent me from capturing the camp. Okay, put one more turn in there. Let's see, is it more important to put the hammer here or get the iron back online? I don't know that there's a right answer there. Gold's doing fine. In fact, gold's doing really well. We could purchase a city-state if we really wanted to. I don't think that's such a good idea. I don't want to blow all my cash right now. I don't know. I'll have to think about that in a second. Oh, look at that. We get that tile just in time for the work boat to appear. So let's go ahead and work that tile for now. No, it's 2 core versus 4. Once I get a work boat down there, it'll be worth the extra food, I think. It's going to take 2 turns. So, horses there. Oh, only 1 gold. That's not happy. Alright, so I'm thinking about what to do with this worker. Well, I want him to build the road, so let's do this, because that way I can come here, do road, yeah. Okay, step and shoot. That way if something else spawns, I can't just take my worker. Alright, settler's done here, so let's get that workshop going. Let's see here. Well, let's see. If I was to step there, he'd be able to go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, come here. Whereas 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, here. And what did I say? If he was here, 1, 2, 3, 4, here. So I actually lose a turn by not doing this. So I'll have him put off the ivory for 1 turn. Okay, is it more important to do workshop or coliseum at this point? Oh, the workboard's about to hook up the crab, so we have some time. Alright, camp there. I guess I could finish scouting this island. Well, I don't know, let's see. Oh, cool. Another ruin. That's good. Yeah, I want to bring these guys here, let Mongolia know I'm still around. Don't get any ideas. Let's see here. Back up the archer, get the melee, more frontline in it. Alright, that's not bad. I'm feeling a little less salty about that now. Just sit tight for this turn. Oh, yeah, finish the salt. Nobody wants to buy it. We are working it, so good to go. And that salt's about to go online, so that's pretty good. And we're just about at time here, so I think I'm going to call it now. We got the fifth natural wonder here. We just thwarted the happiness is doing good. Gold's doing really good. And I want to think about what I want to do with that gold. So I'm going to stop the video here. Hope you enjoyed it. Having lots of fun. It's nice being this wide and not getting into unhappiness. And as I've already explained, it looks like we're going to have a pretty bright future here. So lots of fun to come. See you in the next part. Take care. Thanks again for watching.